Good morning, class 9. We had started a new chapter, that is chapter number 13, the skin. Master of all trades, jack of all trades. Okay, so here particularly we have so far completed the function, the role of the skin we have completed, and then after that now we need to learn about the structures of the skin. The structure of the skin mainly shows two main parts, as it is given in page number 128 if you are going through the book. Okay, now see, this skin shows can be divided into two main parts, or the structure of the skin shows two main parts, that is skin proper and then derivatives of skin. Okay, skin proper includes the structure like epidermis and dermis, and derivatives of skin. Derivatives means which has been derived from this skin proper. Okay, they include here nails, then again mammary gland, sweat gland, sebaceous gland. So one by one we'll be discussing about them. Here in this video today we'll be discussing about the skin proper. Okay, as I told you that it is divided into two parts, that is epidermis and derma. Epidermis and dermis. Okay, first we'll discuss about epidermis. I have drawn the diagram of skin, layers of skin, also particular section of skin. Okay, this also you need to practice. Okay, you may be asked to label or you may be asked to draw also. Okay, a little bit practice required. Okay, let us go through the first part of the skin proper, that is epidermis. Now see how many points we should be learning from here. The first thing we need to understand that epidermis, epi means outer and dermis means skin. So it is the outer part of the skin, okay, which is mainly formed by stratified epithelium. About different types of epithelial tissue you might have learned in the second chapter in animal tissue. Okay, stratified epithelium means the epithelium consists of different layers of different types of epithelial cells. Now the second one is, you need to understand that it is devoid of any blood capillaries or blood vessels. There is no blood vessels. Okay, and some more points are also given here, like the epidermis which covers the palms, sole. Okay, they are usually very thick. Okay, and then again, now the main point is that this epidermis mainly includes three different regions: the outermost, then the middle, then comes the innermost. The outermost layer, okay, the outermost region of this epidermis is called cornified layer, or it is also called as stratum corneum. Okay, stratum corneum, you can see in the figure also, this is the outermost part. Okay, stratum corneum. Okay, it is followed by the middle layer, which we call as the granular layer, and then the innermost layer is called Malpighian layer, or it is also called as stratum Malpighi, or sometimes it is also called as germinative layer. Okay, where it is germinative layer. Okay, now first let us understand about the outermost cornified layer. Okay, this outermost cornified layer, they mainly consist of flattened cells. Flattened means squamous, obviously. Okay, flat type of dead cells. Okay, flattened dead cells, which are mainly made up of protein called keratin. This term you need to remember, maybe ask sometimes. Okay, they are mainly made up of the protein called keratin. Okay, keratin, which is mainly responsible for the formation of hair and all. Okay, these proteins are mostly found in dead cells. Okay, like here, nails, they are all dead cells. Now, again, we need to understand here that the cells in these regions are continually, they are replaced. Okay, continually they are worn out and replaced. Okay, by the cells which arises from the innermost layer, that is Malpighian layer. Okay, about which again we'll discuss later. Then again, after that, the main role of these, the cells of this region, is that it protects us from mechanical damage. Then again, second one is bacterial infection, and the third one is loss of water by evaporation. So these are the points which we can include here Then after that comes middle granular layer. Okay, middle granular layer, they mostly consist of 2 to 3 layers. Okay, and then again layers of flattened cells. Then after that, these cells gradually they become the codified cells. Okay, gradually they become, as they become mature, they get converted into codified, the cells of codified layer. Then after that comes the innermost layer, that is Malpighian layer, which is, as I told you, which is also called stratum Malpighi. Then again, or it is also called germinative layer. Why it is called germinative layer? Because the cells in this region keeps on dividing. They divide actively to produce new cells. Okay, to replace the cells of the outermost layer. Okay, that is codified layer. So the same thing is mentioned here. Actively, the cells in this region actively divides to produce new cells, which replaces the worn-out cells of the outermost codified cells. Okay, so this is about the three different layers of epidermis. As I told you, epi means outer, dermis means skin, outer skin. Now, further, the important point which we can include under this topic is coloration of the skin. Coloration of skin is mainly due to the pigment, a protein pigment called melanin. You need to remember this name, melanin. Now, the amount of melanin present in the skin determines the color of the skin. If it is present in large amount, then mostly the skin is dark color. If it is present in less amount, then usually the skin is fair color. Okay, whitish in color. So that is there. So about the melanin also you need to remember. Then next comes, okay, one more point you need to remember here, that this melanin are usually produced or are usually present in Malpighian layer. Then we need to learn about the abnormal condition of skin. So there are two abnormal condition which is mentioned in the book, that is leucoderma and albinism. Okay, leucoderma, in this case what happens is that melanin is lost from, okay, some portion of the body, okay, which results in the formation of patches. Okay, so that is there. Then, but albinism, in case of albinism, what happens is that there is a complete loss of melanin from the body. Even the hair loses its color. Okay, and then the skin becomes almost pinkish in color, because as no pigment is present in the outermost layer. Okay, so the blood capillaries gets exposed, due to which the person appears pinkish in color. Okay, and again, it is given that this albinism is a hereditary disease, can be transmitted from parents to the offspring. Okay, their children also becomes albino. Okay, albino, their children are usually called albino, albinism. So just now we have completed the epidermis. Now after that we'll discuss about the derma, dermis. Okay, in the next video. In this video, this much, student. Thank you very much.